Welcome everyone. Today we will discuss universal motor. Okay, so this type of motor is a series motor which run in both DC AC supply and DC supply. Okay, with same speed. Okay, so this is the construction. This is the stator. These are poles, stator poles. This is armature. Field windings connected in series with this armature. This is brush. Can be shown like this. So this is field winding, and again field winding. Armature. This is stator. So in this way we can present this, and these are brushes. So it operates approximately with same speed and output when either supplied from AC or DC. Okay, so this type of motor operates approximately at the same speed on either AC or DC. So, but when we give AC supply here, so we have to consider the reactance. Okay, so in AC there will be no problem. Okay, so we have to consider this X, So in DC it will be absent. So in AC we have to consider this reactance and the drop due to this. Okay, so this is a drop in this field and armature. This X is equal to XA plus XS, armature reactance and series field reactance. And you can include compensating winding reactance and interpole reactance if you are added here. Okay, so when owing to this reactance voltage drop which is present on DC, so motor speed is somewhat lower. Okay, so this drop increases. Okay, so therefore ER voltage induced will reduce. Okay, and ER is proportional to N, therefore speed will also reduce. Okay, so when it is given AC supply, so we have to consider the reactance of field and armature. Okay, so the reactance and there will be drop in this reactance I into X, and X is of armature and this series field resistance. And when this drop increases, so the induced voltage or back EMF will reduce, and this back EMF is proportional to speed, so speed will reduce. Okay, and also in the last class we have seen that the speed of AC is directly proportional to, is equal to NDC into cos phi. Okay, so it depends on power factor. So speed when AC supply is given, and this is speed when DC supply is given, and this is the power factor. And also cos phi is equal to 1 minus Ix upon V whole square. Last class we have discussed this. So power factor is equal to 1 minus Ix by V. Okay, so this I am talking about this drop. So if this increases, so power factor decreases, and therefore the speed of this motor also decreases. Okay, so this is the speed current characteristics of the series motor. Okay, so at high speed these are nearly same. Okay, so the speed will always be less than speed in case of DC operation. If current increases, this power factor decreases. So therefore the speed, the power factor for AC series motor is very low during the starting and when it is overloaded, because at that time current is very high. So this drop is very high, so power factor is very low. And this power factor is very high, it is equal to unity at low power, at light loads. Okay, so this will be the speed current characteristics for the series motor, AC series motor. Okay, so to compensate this decrease in speed, we generally choose a pole which has early saturation. Okay, so we generally choose a pole which has early stage saturation. Okay, like this.
So on increasing the magnetic circuit, the peak of sine wave of current.
So corresponding wave of current will reduce.
Okay. So this will reduce the flux. So
this is flux. So here flux will reduce.
So flux, if flux reduces, so speed,
so current reduces. Okay. And then if current reduces, so speed will be high and it will be equal to the speed at DC operation.
Okay, so generally we choose a material, a pole which has early polarization and due to which there will flux will decrease and then current will decrease and speed will increase. Okay, so we can compensate the speed by using this type of poles. Okay. So if you consider this field construction. So the basically inertial motor is similar to DC motor. Okay, so it is similar to DC motor in construction and to reduce the reluctance. So first we have to reduce this reluctance. Okay, so what we do? We use few tons of field windings. Okay, so in order to reduce the reluctance,
reactance X, so we use few turns of field winding.
So in order to reduce this X, we use few turns of field winding as X is proportional to N square. Okay, so we generally use this few series field winding. Okay, and second, when we connect this AC supply, so there will be eddy current losses, eddy current and hysteresis losses. Okay, so to reduce this, we use laminated pole. Okay, so difference from DC motor. In case of DC motor, there are the pole and armature, stator and armature are not laminated. Okay, so for universal motor, when it is supplied to AC supply, so we generally laminate this both stator and armature of the motor. Okay, in order to reduce the eddy current losses. Okay, to reduce. So we use laminated core both for stator and rotor, for field and armature. Okay. And next, we use low reluctance path so rolling might increase and to have better commutation, we increase number of conductors which increase the number of commutator segments. Okay, so we increase armature conductor and commutator segment in order to improve commutation. Okay,
and using low flux density.
Low flux densities.
Okay. So we use material which have low flux densities. Okay. So this will minimize reactance, eddy current, and hysteresis loss. Okay, and so using low flux density, we can reduce transformer EMF. Okay, so by using low flux density, we can reduce transformer EMF. Okay, so this transformer EMF is responsible for poor commutation. Okay, so during commutation, it increases the voltage across the commutating bars, short-circuited commutating bars. Hence, it leads to heavy sparking. Okay, so here this is short circuited commutator bar. Okay, so ET appear across this terminal. Okay, and it increases the voltage across this short circuited conductor. Okay, and there will be heavy sparking, and this will lead to poor commutation. Okay. So this compensating winding are generally used for high rating motors. So for low rating motors, we generally don't use these compensating windings. Okay, so this compensating winding is generally used for high rating motors to improve compensating. Okay, to improve commutation. So this is a universal motor, which is construction is similar to DC motor, and it can run with both AC and DC supply with approximately same speed and power output power. Okay, and some adjustment were made for when it is supplied from AC supply. Okay, so there are some issues due to this AC supply. Okay, and these are how we can eliminate these effects. Okay, due to AC. So the most of the universal motor are designed to operate speed exceeding 3000 rpm, 3500 rpm. Okay. And motor with 800 to 10,000 RPM are common in use. Okay. And this high speed results in small size and weight.
So for high speed, generally the size and weight of the motor is very small. Okay. So now this inertial motor can be divided into two categories. So first is compensated. This is distributed. Distributed field. And second is uncompensated. Or concentrated field. Okay, so this inertial motor is generally of two types: compensated motor and uncompensated motor. In compensated motor, it is field is distributed, and in uncompensated, the field is concentrated. Okay. So this compensated is, as I said, is used for high speed and rating is less than 200 watt. Okay, so it is not smaller output, not used for not exceeding 200 watt. And the motor of concentrated field type is usually a salient pole machine. Okay. So this is salient pole type machine. Okay. So this is salient pole type machine, and windings are concentrated like this. Okay. And in distributed, the windings are distributed like this. This has here the slots and windings are kept in these slots. Okay. And these all are laminated. Okay, so these are laminated ports in order to reduce the eddy current losses. Okay. And distributed field motors have two types: single field compensated motor. It is of two type: single field, and it is single field compensated and two field compensated.
like this. So this two field compensated is generally this are balanced two phase split phase smooth. So the construction is quite similar to two phase split phase motor. So two field compensated winding as a stator winding. Okay. So this two. Two windings, stator winding and compensating winding. Which is 90 degree displaced to stator winding. Okay. So this two field compensating motor has two windings. This is of main field winding. Okay, and compensating winding, which is 90 degree to this elliptically apart to the main winding. So this uncompensated winding has poor speed regulation. Poor speed regulation. And it is less expensive as compared to compensated. So here we are using this compensating winding. So this cost will increase, okay, but it has better voltage speed regulation, okay, and it is less expensive. So distributed field compensated motor is employed for large large power rating, that is 3/4 watt, and speed is 7500 rpm. Okay, so this is power rating distributed type, and for low output range up to 200 watt and 3000 rpm, this is the range. So these are the types of industrial motor. There are two types: compensated, which has distributed field, and uncompensated, which has got concentrated fields. These are salient pole type machine. Okay, and this compensated can be categorized into two parts, single field compensated motor and two field compensated motor. So this two field compensated motor is similar to two phase split phase motor, which we have
studied earlier. Okay, and this has got two windings, the stator winding, which is main field winding and compensating winding, and both these are 90 degree apart to each other. And this uncompensated winding has poor speed regulation and it is less expensive as compared to compensated distributed winding. Okay. So universal motor is high speed motor. Okay, so it is high speed motor. What we can conclude, it is high speed motor and size and weight is small size and weight. Okay, and lighter in weight compared to other motor of same output. So full load power factor is high. Full load power factor is high, which is near 0.5, but low at starting and overload. Okay, because at that time current is high. If current is high, so power factor will be low. Okay. So this is all about universal motor. Okay. So in the last class, so current in undergoing commutation is given by armature, and this current is this coil is undergoing commutation. Okay, so current in coil undergoing commutation is given by ERT by ZSC. Okay, where ERT is made up of two voltages, ER and ET. This is ERT. This is reactance voltage, which is due to self inductance, and this is transformer EMF, which is due to the AC operation of the motor, and this is due to transformer action. And this transformer EMF is responsible for the high voltage across this commutating coil, okay, and which leads to over commutation. Okay, and ZSC is so this is resultant EMF. So this is resultant EMF in coil divided by its impedance. Okay, so how we can improve the commutation? Okay, so if we decrease this ERT, if ERT is decreased or ZSC is increased. Okay, so we can improve commutation by decreasing this resultant EMF. Okay, so we have to decrease this transformer EMF and this reactance EMF and the impedance of the coil undergoing commutation. Okay, so in this way we can, so first is to reduce the RT is reduced, and second ZSC is increased. Resistance. Mainly we increase the resistance. So first, design concentration. Design concentration. So reactance voltage, this ER is equal to LC di by dt. Okay, so this ER is proportional to LC. This is self inductance of the coil. Okay, and LC is proportional to L is proportional to n square, number of turns. Okay, so reactance voltage can be reduced if single turn coil is used. So we use single turned coil. Okay, so reactance EMF is reduced by using this single turn coil. Okay, and also both rotational and transformer EMF depends on flux per pole. Okay, so by using lower value of flux per pole, so by using first by using lower flux per pole. Okay, so both this transformer EMF and this reactance EMF depends on this flux per pole. So if we reduce this flux per pole, so this both this EMF will get reduced. Okay, and having lesser number of turns per coil. Having lesser number of turns per coil. Okay, so we are reducing the number of turns per coil. Okay, so in this way we can reduce reactance voltage and transformer EMF. These are the design considerations. Next, second, by using compensating and interpoles, compensating windings. Poles, interpoles or commutating poles. So in the last class we have seen these both the operation of this compensating winding and this interpole winding. Okay, so compensating winding compensate or utilize the effect of armature EMF, armature flux or armature field, and this interpoles take care of the reactance EMF and transformer EMF. Okay, so in the last class we have discussed this, both the compensating winding and interpoles. Compensating winding utilize the effect of armature flux phi A, and this interpoles utilize the effect of reactance EMF and transformer EMF. Okay, now C is increase ZSC. Okay, so here I is equal to ISC is equal to ERT divided by ZSC. Okay, so in case A and B we are reducing the value of ERT, resultant EMF in commutating coil, and in case in C case we are increasing the value of ZSC. Okay, so how we can increase? So let's suppose this is commutating segments and these are the coils, armature coils. And this is the brush. Okay. So this is the commutator segment, and this is brush. Okay, and these are the coils, armature coils. So what we have to do, we have to increase ZSC, that is we have to increase the resistance. Okay, so what we do, we generally add resistance like this in between the coils. This R is circulating current caused by resultant EMF can be reduced by using hard grade brush, using hard grade brush having large contact resistance, having large contact resistance. Okay. So in order to minimize the short circuit current or to increase ZSC, we use this type of brush, high grade brush having large contact resistance. Okay. So this contact resistance is increased. Okay. Contact between commutator segments and brush. Okay. And connecting additional resistance, resistors between the coils and commutator segment, So these are highly resistive material, and these resistance are placed in same slot, so where armature windings are kept. Okay. So these are resistance R and these are armature winding. So they are kept in same slot. Okay. Armature. And these are connected in parallel, so resultant resistance will be R by 2. Okay, so this resultant resistance will be R by 2 per brush, as seen from the external . So this method reduces the circulating current. Next, D is use of discharge winding. So this methods is generally used in traction methods in railway engines. Okay, employed in single phase traction motor. So next is the use of discharge winding. Okay. So consider this circuit, and this current is I is flowing to this circuit, and this is switch S. Okay. So if we open this switch S, okay, like this, so current is flowing through this RL circuit, so this energy is stored in this Li square, in this inductor, will appear across this terminal as a arc. Okay, so there will be a sparking across this terminal. Okay, so if S is switch across the switch, and if this S is thrown to 1, if it is thrown to 1 like this, okay, so all this energy which is stored in this inductor will be absorbed by this resistance. Okay, so this energy will be absorbed or dissipated in R and R1. Okay, so there will be hardly any sparking between these terminals. Okay, so this resistance is discharging resistance. Okay, so this principle is used for discharging the energy stored in the coil of the commutating the coil which is going to be commutated. Okay, which is going, their commutation is going on. Okay, so inductance of commutated coil during the commutation process. Okay, so types of discharge windings. So this discharge resistance should have sufficiently high resistance. Okay, and there should be no circulating current. Okay, so when this switch is thrown to 1, so there should be no circulating current which flow locally in this circuit. Okay, so first we will study the Robinson's discharge winding. Robinson. So let's suppose these are segment. This is main winding. Okay, and we have discharge winding. These are the discharge windings. Okay. And both are kept in same slots. So
endings, and these are discharge nodes. Okay, like this. So these are discharge winding, and these are main. Discharge winding are double layer windings. These are double layer windings. Okay. High resistance and thin wire. So this has got discharge winding should have high resistance. Basically, this I square, half I square, half and I square. Okay. High resistance and thin wire. Okay. And they are placed on the top of the slots. So discharge winding are kept on the top of the slot, and the main winding kept in the bottom of the slot. Okay. And main winding have thick wire. So how does it work? So these main windings are short pitched. Main windings are short pitched. Okay. So generally it should, this is 180 degree. So this is full pitch. This violet color is full pitch. Okay. And they are short pitched by epsilon angle. Okay. And discharge windings are over pitched. Discharge winding are over pitched with the same angle epsilon. Okay, this is also epsilon by same. Okay, so this main windings are short pitched, and the discharge winding are over pitched. Okay. So the EMF induced in main winding, EF, this EF and HG, the EMF induced in EMF and SG are equally induced in DC and AB. Okay. So EMF induced is EF will be equal to this voltage, will be equal to this voltage. E DC and E HG, this voltage induced in this coil will be equal to E, this will be CD and AB.
Okay, so voltage induced on the two different coils of main winding is equal to voltage induced in this coil and this coil of the discharge winding. Okay, so if we trace this path A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, and again A, and if we apply KVL, so as both are equal, so net voltage will be zero. Okay, so the resultant induced voltage induced EMF will be equal to is zero. Okay, if you apply KVL in this loop A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, this voltage equal to this voltage and this voltage is equal to this voltage. Okay, so if you apply KVL, so resultant induced voltage will be zero, and this will avoid any circulating current in parallel coils. Okay, so there will be no circulating current. Okay, and energy stored in this L of this main winding will be discharged in this high resistive discharge winding. Okay. So voltage induced, this is in discharge winding and this is in main winding. Okay, so both are equal. So this is discharge winding EMF and this is main winding here. Similarly here, this will be same. This will be same. Okay. So what we are doing, we are short pitching this main winding. Generally, for full pitch coil, it is 180 degree. Okay, so it is displaced from 180 degree from epsilon on both the side. Okay, and this discharge winding, which is double layer winding and is has got high resistance, is over pitched with same angle. Okay, so this angle will be same. So voltage induced in this coil HG and this side EF will be equal to voltage induced in AB and voltage induced in BC. So we can see this. Okay, so this is voltage induced in discharge winding, this is in main winding, both are equal, and this is in main winding and this is in discharge winding. Okay, so if we apply, if we consider this loop A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H and again A, so if we apply KVL, so resultant EMF will be zero and there will be no circulating current. Okay, and the energy stored in this main winding will get dissipated in
the resistance of discharge winding. Okay, so this is about Robinson discharge winding, and last we will see duplex discharge winding. This is duplex B discharge winding. So these are commutator segments. These are main winding. Main duplex. These are discharge winding. Okay, so this is 100% pitch, full pitch. It is 100% pitch, and this is 1/4. Is 33% pitch. So main duplex winding is full pitched coil, and this discharge winding is 33%, 33.3%.
it is 1/3. Okay.
So duplex winding consists of full pitch coil and discharge has two coils in series, each of 33%.
So discharge has two winders. Have two coils in series. Two coils in series. Okay, so these two coils are in series and they are 33.3%
pitched. So discharge winding is parallel with main, so that place the EMF induced into discharge coil is in, okay, so EMF induced into,
so EMF induced into coils is equal to
EMF induced in two coils in series equal to EMF induced in
EMF induced in main duplex winding. So EMF induced in this two series winding is equal to EMF induced in main duplex winding. Okay. Okay. So again, if you take the KVL equation, so net induced resultant EMF induced will be 0. Will be equal to 0. Okay, as voltage induced in this main duplex winding is equal to voltage induced in this parallel connected to this discharge, this main winding in which are connected in series. Okay, so the resultant will be same. Resultant will be equal to 0, and there will be no circulating current. Okay. So this is all about the improving the commutation process. Okay, so this is, that's all for today's class. Any doubt?
Okay then, thank you then.